So people often ask us, why art in a place, the Marine Mammal Center, which is a hospital. It's a hospital for injured and ailing marine mammals of all kinds. And we like to say it's because art is a healing force, and that we want to work our artistic magic not only on the marine mammals there, but also on the human visitors that come.
And there are emotional and hormonal responses to really great art. It happens, and it happens all the time. And it happens when we go to the ocean. When you go to the ocean, it's this amazing place. That, first of all, it's what's in our bodies. Our blood is the same composition as seawater. And we come from the ocean, and we get refreshed by the ocean.
The origin of this installation is in the idea of the ghost below. And what is the ghost below? It's what we can't see. It's what we don't know. You look out onto the vastness of the ocean, and there's incredible depth there. And there is floating in that depth these things called ghost nets. They are derelict fishing gear that's gotten loose. And as they're rising and falling in the ocean, they're collecting up turtles and marine mammals and fish, and it rises and falls as this accumulation of terribleness.
And Indra's net is also made of fishing net. They're just retrieved from different places. The fishing net that's hanging over the courtyard is from a trawl net. And trawl nets are really nefarious pieces of fishing gear because they have a great mouth, and this great mouth scoops up everything in its path.
Indra was a Hindu god, and he cast a net over the entire universe. At every knot or juncture of the net, there was a small jewel, and each jewel reflected every other jewel. So we have at the Marine Mammal Center cast a net. It's about 40 feet by 40 feet. And at about 1,000 junctures, we have adhered a white cap that we collected, a lid to a bottle that we found on Kehoe Beach. And inside of that cap, there is a small round mirror. So too, our net is reflecting the universe.
It's basic ecological theory that everything is connected to everything else. John Muir said it. When you tug on one thread of the universe, you pull the whole thing with you. Over 94% of climate change happens in the ocean. So we really have to pay attention to what's going on in the ocean. Indra's net, with all of the mirrors, puts you in the picture so that we all start to take responsibility. One of the things that the Marine Mammal Center has done is they have put a creation station up. So what you can do is you can write your promise on a tag that is hung from the Indra's net hanging over the courtyard, and people are invited to make their promises.
It's really about the viewer and the community participation that the piece itself will evoke. And it's really exciting to see more and more and more of the pledges and promises being added every week. And not only do we want people to be thoughtful, but we also want them to be uplifted. Kind of that aha moment. People walk into the courtyard and they look up and they see this enormous net and the glittering of the mirrors and this globe of the earth rolling across the surface. And they go, oh,
and thousands of promises fluttering
in the breeze. We're all in this together. We all each are one of those gems on the net. And we are also each other's reflections, in each other that we see ourselves, and in the ocean that we see ourselves. So this real interconnection of life is what I'd like them to experience and have a real embodied sense of it.
In schools, you can educate kids. Once they get a hold of this, they really love the idea of, oh, I'm not going to use a straw anymore. I'm going to find another way. I'm going to ask my mom, don't take plastic bags anymore.
This idea of the ghost below, what we don't see, what we don't know.
It's the place where the human imagination lives, below the surface of our daily lives. And when we reach into that place, which is our unconscious or our dream life, when you reach into that place, there's new information that can really help the world. Every heartbeat, you can remember that the ocean is inside of you, in your blood. Your blood is the ocean. Every heartbeat.